Okay, in this video I'm going to begin exercise 2A in the book Fundamental Applied Mathematics and run page number 41 of the book. So the first question states that a car accelerated uniformly from rest to 10 meters per second in 5 seconds. Draw the time velocity graph and find. Now it says the time velocity graph. I think that's you when you're talking about graphs you will always say what's on the y-axis first, so it's actually a velocity time graph. That's y-axis and then your x-axis. So y-axis first, then your x-axis. So anyway, we'll draw, first of all, our velocity time axis by drawing. As I said earlier on, you only need this particular quadrant because you cannot have negative times and you cannot have negative velocities. So this one, I'm going to say v represents speed. I know they're not velocities, but we'll just say speed. By the way, just once again, a velocity is a vector, therefore it has direction and magnitude, whereas a speed is just a scalar and it only has magnitude. So what he's actually said, it accelerated uniformly from rest to whatever it is, and this is draw a time velocity graph. It actually should say a time speed graph, but we won't get bogged down in these things. So anyway, but I'm still going to use the letter V here. Anyway, time. Remember, time is measured in seconds, and velocity or speed is measured in meters per second, like that. Oh, that's poorly drawn. Excuse me. Like this, meters per second. So, it accelerated from rest. So where is... It starts out, we'll say, time t is equal to zero. Where's time t is equal to zero? That's at the origin in here. It starts at rest. That means its velocity is equal to zero. Where's v equal to zero? It's at the origin. So we know that it begins here, like that. Then it goes from it goes to 10 meters per second in 5 seconds. So let's just break up our thing here. We'll say 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds, like that. Like this. It goes to 10 meters per second. So we'll say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 10. 2, 4. I won't fit in all of them because it just make the thing look a bit cluttered. So we know that after 5 seconds, he's at 10 meters per second. Now it doesn't say that the acceleration. Oh, it does. It says the acceleration is uniform. What that means is that the car didn't do this. It means it's accelerated, acceleration has not changed. If it's uniform, it does not change. So that means you've a straight line. You can draw two of them, you can join the two of them. It's accelerated uniformly or constantly. And a line like this represents that something is done constantly. So we're asked to draw the time velocity graph and find the acceleration. So how do we find the acceleration? Remember, acceleration... Oh, that's... is the rate of change of speed with respect to time. So I know we have our UVAS formulas, but basically that means, well, if you'll have T1 and you'll have T2, you'll take them away, that's the change of V2 minus V1, that's the change of speed, and you divide it by time to get your time, and that'll give you your acceleration. But if you look at our UVAST formulas, we have things like, we have V squared is equal to U squared plus 2AS. We have V is equal to U plus AT. We have S is equal to UT plus half AT squared. And we have, what's the other one I'm missing? S is equal to U plus V over 2 times T. So what we're going to do is, we're going to analyze this motion using those formulae. It's very simple. So, we'll go as follows. We'll write down UVAST, U, V, A, S, T. Okay, the initial velocity is equal to 0 meters per second. The final velocity is equal to 10 meters per second. The acceleration, we don't know. The distance, we don't know. And the time, we know to be 5 seconds. So how do we work this out then? Well, I'm just going to say that A is equal to small a like that, because we don't know what it is. Now, what are the formulas? V is equal to U plus AT. So that's V is equal to 0 plus A times 5. Like that. Therefore, we'll say 5A is equal to 10. A is equal to 2 meters per second squared. Just check the back of the book to see if we're correct. That's squared. I'm having a bit of an off day. Excuse me. Sorry. It's a speed, so it's meters per second. Okay, so that's correct. And next we're asked to find the distance covered. So there are a couple of ways of doing this. So we'll say that the distance is equal to S. Like that. Okay, so V squared is equal to U squared plus 2AS. So let's have a look at that. V squared is equal to U squared plus 2AS. So that means that 10 squared is equal to 0 squared plus 2 times the acceleration, which is now known as 2 times S. So 100 is equal to 4S. S is equal to 100 over 4. S is equal to 25. Is that correct? Yes, 25 meters. That's correct. Now, is there another way of doing this? Yes, there is. If you look at my video on, we'll say, equating distances in the area under the curve, you'll know that a distance corresponds to the area under the speed time graph. That's a fact. Okay? I wouldn't worry about why it is a fact, but just accept that. So just to prove that this is the case, go back to our graph here. How do we get the area of this graph? Well, first of all, we drop our perpendicular. What's the area of a triangle? Half the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. Okay? So the base is 5 units in length, or 5, we'll say, seconds in length. So we go half 5 times the perpendicular height is 10. So that's 5 times 5 is equal to 25 meters. And if that's what we found, that is exactly as we found. So you can get the distance either by using the UFAS formula, or you can use the area of the graph. Now, this was a very simple one, and it's not all of them are as straightforward as that. So, thanks for watching. Pass it on to your friends, and please subscribe to my channel.